Welcome to TGTV. My name's Joel Tadman. I'm the instruction editor, and this is Kit Alexander. He's our features writer, and it's been another exciting week in the world of golf. Before we get onto the tour events, Kit, I know you've been sunning yourself in Orlando last week. Tell us a bit about that and what you're up to.
I have, Joel. Fantastic week. The PGA merchandise show, of course. If you've been following us on Twitter throughout the last week or so, you'll have seen all the regular updates with the latest news from the show. And well, what an incredible week it was. My first time out there. Started off on Tuesday, we had an hour with Graham McDowell shooting some exclusive instruction tips for a forthcoming supplement that I know you'll be heavily involved in over the spring. He'll basically be helping you sharpen all your short game skills from chipping, pitching and bunker play. One of the top players on the planet, so plenty of good stuff I've got out there and lots of great insight to look out for in the coming months in TG. On Wednesday it was on to the demo day at the largest golf range in America. It's basically a massive donut. Every manufacturer on the planet with a stand around the outside, everyone hitting into the middle, tried a hell of a lot of clubs, and it was a great experience. Two clubs really stood out for me, Joe. That was the Adams Super S Hybrid. First time I've tried it. It's in a lot of tour players' bags at the moment. Adams, well known for being one of the best hybrid manufacturers on tour, even without the money to splash around for lucrative sponsorships with players. There's still lots of guys using them, and I absolutely loved it. There'll be lots more on that in a forthcoming issue as well, and the video of me hitting it and the technical guys telling us all about that club up online very shortly. And the second club I was particularly impressed with, TaylorMade R1 driver. I had a little bit of a fitting, it improved my stats a little bit. Very knowledgeable TaylorMade fitters, and I know that's a club you've hit and you quite enjoyed as well.
Absolutely, Kit. Yeah, loads of loft settings, loads of face angle settings, and I did have a hit with it a few weeks ago, and the thing that really stood out for me was the forgiveness on off-centre hits. You know, you could hit it out of the club face and the ball flight was still pretty straight. So yeah, I was a big fan of it. I'm not sure about the sound of it. I think that'll put some people off, but ultimately, if it goes straight down the middle every time, you're going to put it in the bag. So yeah, I was a big fan of the R1.
I agree on the ball speed. It just felt like it flew off the club face wherever you got it, so you can't go wrong with that. And then we were indoors to the convention centre for the Thursday and the Friday. It was a small town, basically. The whole golfing industry in America, all in one place. It was an incredible show, hundreds and hundreds of stands. A couple of other things that I picked up on while I was there. There's a golf app called Swing Smart, which we featured in a recent issue, which is very, very good. Basically, you attach it to the hosel of your golf club, and then it automatically downloads what your swing is and shows an image of it on an app on your iPad or iPhone. There's analysis, all of the stats that you need, and there are videos from Peter Costas as well, telling you little bits on how you can improve. Also, a little bit quirky, Totem Tees, a fully biodegradable golf tee which offers less friction, so apparently more distance. We brought some back, we're going to be giving them a go, so you never know, it could be a tee revolution on the horizon. And then, of course, we've had the tour events over the weekend, Joel, which I know you've been keeping a very close eye on.
Absolutely, yeah. So last week was the Qatar Masters, and it was a breakthrough week this week for England's Chris Wood, who picked up his first European Tour event, winning by a shot from Sergio Garcia and George Kurtsia. He needed a birdie down the last to get into the playoff, but hit a stunning 6-iron from 206 yards to about 15 feet and rolled in the putt for an eagle for a sensational win. Really happy for Chris. He's a really good guy and a talented golfer, and I'm sure he'll push on from there. We also had Tiger Woods winning the Farmers Insurance Open at Torrey Pines. Tiger's record there is absolutely ridiculous, and he was obviously the hot favourite before it started, and he didn't disappoint. An interesting fact for you, actually, about Tiger Woods. Every time he's won his first PGA Tour event, he's averaged 6 wins that season, so look out for Tiger this year. It could be a monumental win for him where he could get him back into the major winners' circle. Kit, it's the Dubai Desert Classic this week over on the European Tour. Who are your picks for that?
It is. Well, there's a couple of guys I think we all need to keep an eye on. Firstly, Sergio Garcia. I think he's going to continue his good form from last week. A little bit of heartbreak for today's golfer with Chris Wood's eagle. A magnificent finish, but it did cost today's golfer a £100 payout on a Sergio Garcia win in TGTV the bookies, so mixed emotions there, but I think he'll continue his good form this week. And secondly, Lee Westwood, first appearance of 2013, tailed off a little bit towards the end of last year, Still looking for that first major, but slipped to world number 8 now, not quite grabbing the headlines. He's going to really want to make a big impact on tour this season, so I think he might be looking to hit the ground running. What about your picks, Joel?
Yeah, some good picks there, Kit. For me, I'm going to go with Tongchai Jaidi. He's had a good season so far, had some good finishes in the Middle East, and I really think he could continue that this week. But also Henrik Stenson picked up his first win in a while, at the end of last season in South Africa, had some good finishes in the Middle East so far, and is a Dubai resident, so knows the course really well. He's acclimatised to the conditions, and he's playing well, so he should contend this week. So he's my pick for the Dubai Desert Classic.
There we go. Plenty to look forward to. You can keep an eye on if our picks actually come good on coverage over the weekend. And join us again in about a week's time for more Today's Golf for Television. Enjoy your golfing. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.